Frau Müller, she only works with the best. And whoever she chooses, she sees raw talent. And she sort of picked me, said, I think she can make it. Frau Müller was always the one cracking the whip and making sure that I would work hard enough. But at the same time, she was wonderful.
That was two-time Olympic gold medal figure skater Katarina Witt in the upcoming documentary The Diplomat, the latest in ESPN's 9 for 9 series. And Katarina Witt joins us now. It's great to have you on the show.
Good morning.
It's amazing looking at that video. I want to actually go backwards and start with 1984 and 88 when you won the gold because you were under pressure. Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Can you imagine?
No.
I can't imagine. But you were under more pressure than people might have even assumed. What was the difference between gold and silver for you?
Well, the difference definitely is most of the time you say you lose gold and you don't say you win silver.
Right.
So definitely being on this level, you really want to go and win the gold. And it was really important for me, especially my second gold medal in Calgary, because it was really about, am I allowed to keep skating or should I stay in the country for the rest of my life?
So you couldn't leave the country unless you won the gold medal.
Yes, it was sort of a deal, yes. Little we knew that the wall would come down a year later.
Yeah, what did you? What did you know? Did you have any idea?
Couldn't you just wait it? No, that's pretty amazing. Tell us about your coach. That we're seeing, and you're talking a little bit about her in the documentary.
Yeah.
What an incredible bond.
Yeah. No, she discovered me when I was 9, and of course I was a little girl, and then she stayed with me for the rest of my career. And I think it's not easy to discover somebody who's a girl and then go through the time when you grow as a woman and everything what comes to become a woman.
Yeah.
And she was a tough woman, tough cookie, but I guess I was one of those who needed it. You know how I say she needs to crack the whip, but any athlete in this class, you ask, you know that a coach is so important, and a coach on your side who pushes you and keeps pushing you.
You know, it's funny because there's so many questions to have for you, and the East German sporting culture has been often satirized in this country, you know. But what I wanted to sort of start with was what we talked about off camera. When the wall came down and you got your freedom, you came to New York, you said, well, I was really too young to enjoy it. You almost had to relearn how to have a sense of adventure.
Yeah.
Right.
Learn how to enjoy freedom. You know, I mean, I had my freedom within my sport. I was lucky enough because I was promoted there and supported. But because coming to New York here now, and I wasn't here for the last few years, and staying in my neighborhood where I lived, and I realized walking that places, and then realizing that yes, I was in the 90s. I was mid 20 and. End of 20, but it took a few years to really learn how to enjoy your freedom, how to walk alone on the streets without having somebody watching you or always.
And you were watched.
Somebody and
They had files on you, the secret police, and they followed your every move.
They did, since I was 8 years old. They thought she could be a talent and we'll watch her and until the wall came down, basically, yes.
How do you feel about young people in Germany that don't know the history of what you went through? Are they interested? Are they curious?
It's a mixture of, in some ways it's great that they grew up with a completely different sense of democracy and freedom. And I feel in a way fortunate that I had both, you know, that luckily the sport was supported. So I became this two-time Olympic champion in a system which helped athletes. So in this way, that was a plus. And now, of course, with all the changes and young people growing up in a different kind of country, it's great to see, but it's, on the other hand, nice to see when they ask questions, you know, and then you answer and they still don't understand and get it, what it was.
It's
and
hard
it's sort
to
of
imagine.
Like, what, you had a Berlin Wall, what wall? A Chinese wall?
I love it. The Diplomat, part of ESPN's 9 for 9 series, premieres tomorrow at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Katarina Witt, thank you so much. It's
thank
great
you
to see you.
Me.
See, you're here for another reason besides the Christmas tree lighting.
Yeah.
See?
Fantastic
things change.
To see the place in the summer.
Look forward to seeing this.